at some point I was made aware that I was auditioning for the role of Tommy, which baffled me because I didn't have curly, long blonde hair, and you know, so I couldn't figure out how that could be, because if you don't look like Roger Daltrey, how are you going to play Tommy? But I came in and I read for Dez, and then they went away. They went to New York, they went to other places to see more people, and I just, you know, that was another one of the auditions that I had done in that, you know, month. And I went, and I was in the middle of the show, and which also, it was around the time of the Rodney King riots, and we were performing in downtown LA on the night that that all started. So, you know, my focus and my attention was kind of elsewhere. And then a few weeks later, I heard from the production that they wanted me to come and play the role of Tommy, which was unbelievable and fantastic. This was for La Jolla, for the original production. And so I said, you know, that's amazing. And I went and rented the movie again to watch it, because I'd seen it as a kid. But, you know, I remember just being really kind of baffled by it. And I watched it again and remained pretty much baffled by it, because it's kind of more about Ken Russell than it is about The Who, really, or the story. I love the movie, but I could not figure out how they were going to do all those baked beans pouring out onto the stage every night, and, you know, the guy doing Pinball Wizard in these enormous Doc Martens was going to break his neck, and, like, I couldn't imagine what this production was going to be on stage. And they hadn't given us any page from the script. All we had to work off of was the recording, really, and the movie. So I showed up for my first rehearsal in La Jolla, just completely a blank page. And we sat down, and the first thing we did was have a read through, like it was a straight play, like just read the text as a text alone, which I love and which I think is great, because I come at everything from an acting standpoint before musical standpoint. I'm very text oriented, so I always, my way into a song is always through the lyric, really. There were some songs like Fiddle About that, you know, were made a little less sense to do in a reading, you know, but we stuck to it and, you know, read every fiddle. And I remember, I've got it someplace on my script at the end of that first day. I wrote something on the front page. There's something like, you know, this is the real thing, or this is going to be, I knew that it was going to be meaningful and significant. And I didn't mean that this is going to be a huge hit, or this is going to be, you know, the great critically acclaimed success that it was. I just meant that, like, this was, like, culturally, historically meaningful and significant, and that I got to be part of it. I knew it was going to change my life somehow. And I was, you know, I was very right. It was fantastic. If you were setting out to write the dream way to be introduced to Broadway and musical theater, like, our experience was that. The truth burns so bright it can melt winter snow. A towering figure, so brilliant, so high. A white sun burning the earth and the sky.